Welcome back to another edition of the 16th anniversary Tongue in the Post Folk Music Festival put on by the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club here in beautiful Medicine Hat in this beautiful kiln here in Madelta Potteries, one of the historic gems of our community. Another nice, beautiful, sunny day in Medicine Hat. I think we're plus two today. You can't complain about that in January. We've got a very special friend joining us today. We haven't had Dave back for a couple years. Made the big trek all the way from Lethbridge. Dave's been putting out some beautiful music for many years, and we're always happy to have him with us. We're happy to have you guys all with us joining us today. Without getting into a whole bunch of things to start things off, we'll jump in with Dave and carry it on for the next hour, and we'll have a little chat when things are done. Dave McCann, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, I can't thank you enough, Robert, and everybody down here at the Medicine Hat Folk Club and everything that you guys do for musicians, during this really kind of strange time in performing history. I feel fortunate to be able to be on stage here with you all today, and thank you for ducking out of work early and getting out of your Zoom meetings or whatever you're doing out there, and being here for some music. Here we go. Sometimes folks ask me what my songs are about. Sometimes I don't even know. This one was written for a tumbleweed. When you do this gig, you sort of do a lot of driving. And this particular night
I had finished a gig in Canmore. And I was driving back down to Lethbridge. And the wind was just cooking
across the roads. And, every once in a while an owl would swoop in front of my headlights and keep me awake. And it's that kind of time of night where you're, kind of getting a little bit sleepy, and you kind of have to roll your hair up in the window so that, if you do fall asleep, it sort of pulls your head and you can keep driving. Anyways, the wind was pushing these tumbleweeds across the road in front of me, and they looked like dogs on fire. And sometimes when you're married to a songwriter, it's not uncommon to be 4 o'clock in the morning and you hear someone shuffling around down in the kitchen writing songs. It's called Rolling Down the Mountain. And I've been rolling distant as the day been calling, but trailing off to nothing in a world gone wrong.
Rolling down the mountain like it.
dog on fire. I'm casting out my minutes like the ghosts that blow away. Tumbling in the headlights, watch them burn. Guys, appreciate it. Well, has anybody out there ever played at a kite festival? I got the wonderful chance to play at a kite festival one time in Swift Current, and we got there, and I come from Lethbridge, so I kind of thought I knew wind, but I'll tell you, it was windy as heck. The tent was like swaying back and forth. It was like being on a pirate ship or something. And we played the gig, got in the car the next morning to drive back to Alberta, and by the time we hit the Alberta-Saskatchewan border, they had said that Canmore was being evacuated because it had been flooded. And I guess this big storm, these tornadoes came out of the Midwest and sort of hit the Rocky Mountains and started flooding here in Alberta. And by the time I dropped my friend off in Bowness, we both sort of looked at the river and thought, man, that looks high. So I dropped him off, and they ended up getting evacuated. And he took his guitars and put them on the main floor. And I know he went up and saw the news footage about the floods down in Bowness. So he actually swam back, snuck past the police barricades to rescue the guitars with his nephew. And they rescued the guitars. But it was an amazing time to be in Alberta and see so many people come together. And, such a big emergency. And they really sort of pulled it together. And there were so many amazing people that really sort of helped out. It's a pretty good thing. This is a song called Headlights and Halos. Don't pine. distance. Where you stay is where you stand. Won't rest through the silent circle. Out beyond the storm-torn land. Thunder heads out across the open plains. They light the minds of the ghostly town. You kiss the clouds and you call it even. Headlights. Appreciate it. Well, before I had kids, me and my wife, my in-laws, they loved to go down to Arizona and snowbird down there. And we were in our 30s, and they told us how fun it was. And we thought, well, hell, maybe we can go do that. Maybe we can be snowbirds. So we drove down to Arizona, and we wandered around down there in the desert, went out to Joshua Tree, some other places. It was pretty fun. And we discovered that it is like spring break for retired people. They have these little trailer courts, and every single night everybody was gunned up out of their mind, whipping around. They have invented this drink called beer garitas, where they mix beer and margaritas together, and they drive around in these little golf carts having a great old time. And we also discovered that if you do break down anywhere near these places, there's like at least 15 Alberta farmers that come over and fight over what's wrong with your vehicle, and they want to help you fix it. It's an amazing thing. It really is. It's pretty cool. This is a song about wandering around down in the desert. It's called Snake Bit. Thank you. copperhead thrashing. Time steals from reckless hands. Silence fired out into the night. Star-bitten love, slow-burning sky. Stone-torn hearts, kindred entwined. You guys, thanks for being here. Thanks for being here for live music. You know, I sort of ended up in Alberta. I grew up in Peterborough, Ontario, and then I ended up out here. And I just sort of started playing on the streets. I would busk up in Calgary, Alberta, where I lived, and we'd go down to Electric Avenue back in the heyday, and we'd be playing for people. And you know, there'd be people vomiting in the bushes, and the police would be, you know, dragging people off after they were fighting. And, you know, growing up in Peterborough, that was pretty common scenery, I guess, on a Friday night outside the bars. And, you know, we just sort of started playing on the streets and gradually started playing in clubs. But for years, I had this band called Dave McCann and the Ten-Toed Frogs, and we'd play folk events. And eventually, we ended up changing the name of the band to Dave McCann and the Firehearts. We went down to Nashville and made a record with Will Kimbrough down there, who worked with Emmy Lou Harris and Rodney Crowell and Todd Snyder and a bunch of other amazing artists, Shamika Copeland. And it was a great experience. And we were lucky. It was good. And, you know, this is a song off that record. This is called Standing in the River. I guess, you know, if you're a river person or you're a fly fisher person that lives out here in Alberta, there's a lot of amazing rivers. And I was lucky because our kids were quite small when grandma and grandpa took them fishing for the first time. And they went to this little lake out in the Crow's Nest Pass called Lee Lake. And it was like the opening day of trout. And they caught 15 trout in the first 10 minutes, I'm pretty sure of it. And now every time I take those kids fishing, they're like, Dad, you suck. This is boring. You don't even know what you're doing. Grandma and Grandpa know what they're doing. So this one's for grandparents. This is called Standing in the River. Well, you could find yourself waiting for the one who won't show. It's all smoke, mirrors, gasoline on a road nobody should know. Well, cast off a neon and headlights, remembered and broke down again. Waiting on paper and pesos, paper and pesos, forever, amen. And I should be standing in the river, my friend. We should be standing. goes down, yeah, the river don't end. And I've been so stickled and stone fleet, the gift horse always seemed to complain. Muds up and gone, something like a rope washed out in the rain. And there's a dry dog waiting on the prairie, waiting out there alone, waiting on paper and pesos, paper and pesos, lost in the fold. And I should be standing in the river, standing in the river, my friend. We should be standing in the river goes down, yeah, the river. Guys, well, like I said, I grew up in Peterborough, Ontario, and I ended up out here. And we had that band, Dave McCann and the Ten-Toed Frogs. And when we were playing out on the streets, we stumbled into this. This is previous to Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? You could still find a banjo in a pawn shop. And we stumbled into a pawn shop and found a banjo. And we thought, oh, that's cool. Let's get that thing. So we bought that. And we'd play in little places like Natton, Alberta, and other places. But I remember in Natton, you know, there wasn't too many shops around. When you play at the hotel there, the Auditorium Hotel, you'd have to wander around the streets in the daytime looking for something to do, and there's nothing but antique shops. You know, Kevin, our friend Kevin there, told us, you know, it's hard to find tires in this town. You can find 15 different kinds of wagon wheels, but it's tough to find tires for your truck. So we stumbled around, and we found, like, a couple old jugs and some washboard. It was like a music shop. We just found this stuff, and then we kind of figured maybe, you know, because we had a banjo, we were, you know, a bluegrass band, because we didn't know any better. And we would just sort of play some sort of, you know, songs that we sort of discovered were kind of like bluegrass songs. I guess we would just sort of go into record land and find records that had, you know, any kind of banjo song on there. We had discovered, you know, that old Loudon Wainwright song, Dead Skunk in the Middle of the Road. It was this sort of number one hit about roadkill in the 70s, and we would sort of play that song, and we had a couple other songs, so we decided that maybe we were a bluegrass band. So we went to a bluegrass festival, and they had this thing called a bluegrass band competition. So we ended up entering into this bluegrass band competition, and we got up and played our songs. And I don't know if anybody's ever been to a bluegrass festival, but I'm sure some of you people out there have. And for us who were used to either playing on the streets or in a club, or you know, someone was at least giving you some kind of courtesy groove. But at a bluegrass festival, it's just a sea of people who they kind of look ticked off. They're just sort of in their lawn chairs. And it's not until there's a banjo solo or a mandolin solo that everybody goes wild and claps. And then they go back to stone face. So it was a little unnerving. But I remember we got this wonderful critique at the end of it. And it said, not bluegrass, underlined a bunch of times. Dress unsuitable for stage. Sloppy presentation. The banjo has been strummed. So we hopped back in the van and we left. This guy that I was driving down there with, he had this old 1980s sort of black boogie van, and it had a big white skull in the window, and we were playing Jethro Tull. And we left the Bluegrass Festival disappointed, unsure. And I remember weeks later, we were telling someone about it, and he said, well, clearly, you guys are not a bluegrass band. You guys are an Appalachian skiffle band. And we thought, oh, well, I guess that's what we are. We're an Appalachian skiffle band. I think at one point, maybe we were like the third best Appalachian skiffle band in Alberta, maybe. Who knows? Anyways, we changed the name of our band to the Firehearts. And this is a song called Fireheart. You guys, appreciate it. So yeah, we had that band named Dave McCann and the Ten-Toed Frogs, and drunk people would always come up to us and say, what's the name of your band? Well, and we named it that because when we had that banjo and we were playing that Loudon Wainwright song, there was a line in that song that says, you got your dead cat, you got your dead dog on a moonlight night, you got your dead toad frog. And we were playing with this mandolin player, and he was singing something else. And we said, well, what are you singing? And he said, well, it's Ten Toed Frog, isn't it? And so we laughed, and we named the band that, Dave McCann and the Ten Toed Frogs. For years, we had that. But we discovered that when you get to the border in Saskatchewan going to Nashville to make a record, and you tell them at 3 o'clock in the morning that you're going to Nashville to make a record, they separate you into these little tiny rooms. And the room that I was in was wallpapered with America's Most Wanted, and I was just like looking at the walls thinking, man, this is going to be scary. Anyways, this guy came in. He was the meanest border guard guy you've ever seen. You know, the kind of stereotypical, like, you know, like Looney Tunes. It was almost like steam was coming out of his ears. Asked me how much they were paying me to go to Nashville to make a record, and I said, well, no, we're contributing to the American economy lots when we go down there. Anyways, he asked me a bunch of other questions, and he got to the one question, which was, what's the name of your band? And I said, well, it's Dave McCann and the Ten-Toed Frogs. And the meanest border guard in the whole world just burst out laughing. And he said, oh, you guys can go. Go have some fun. Don't forget to stop here when you're famous on the way back. So we went down to Nashville and made a record, and it was so much fun. And that's the thing about this job, is you spend a lot of time driving. There's a song called Ain't No Highway Can Hold Me. before we're taken by the glow. The love of shine and ruin never found it in their ways. But time's the only gold beheld, lost on gilded grace. Thank you, guys. Well, where I grew up, it was just sort of osmosis, I guess. I grew up on a steady diet of AC/DC and Iron Maiden and metal music, really, I guess. My mom always had sort of AM country music on, and it was kind of the novelty stuff. I guess in the 80s, it was kind of like, you know, you would hear songs like, I'm going to hire a wino to decorate your home, and, you know, sort of Elvira and all these sort of novelty country songs. So I kind of rejected that music and sort of started chasing rock and roll. I guess it wasn't until I discovered maybe Bob Dylan in high school or something that I decided that that's when I wanted to play guitar. Kind of fell in love with acoustic bass music and just sort of started chasing music backwards, or sort of digging and finding old blues music. You know, when you discovered what Dylan was up to, you went through the whole New York folk revival thing, and then you got the old blues music, and then, you know, you would start digging backwards and finding the root of what was going on with songs.
I remember that around that time,
Steve Earle had sort of came out with this record called Copperhead Road, and I sort of had sort of liked it, so I sort of started digging in on these Texas songwriters. And I just remembered that, you know, when you dug backwards from, you know, from Steve, you found Guy Clark, and then you found, like, Townes Van Zandt. And I always sort of liked that kind of stuff, you know, these long story songs that were interesting. And I know Steve Earle has that story he sort of tells about, you know, being in the 70s and the 80s and trying to, you know, have hit songs. And their publishers were like, yeah, we don't want to hear these long story songs that you guys have. We want to hear, like, hit songs, like, because Rhinestone Cowboy's the hit right now. Write us another Rhinestone Cowboy. And he says that, like, 3 months later, there was this Canadian guy by the name of Gordon Lightfoot who came out with an 8-minute song about a shipwreck that went to number one. And those guys were like, yeah, I guess Canada's pretty cool. So, you know, that's the thing. I got the chance to go up to Banff to work at a songwriter residency up there with this great Texas, Oklahoma songwriter by the name of Kevin Welsh. And he was telling me, you know, you really should dig in and try and write a story song. And it's kind of tough, but I sort of took a stab at it. I was sort of reading about the Great Depression. And, you know, growing up in Peterborough, Ontario, I sort of decided to hitchhike out to Alberta the first time I came out this way. And it only lasted maybe 3 weeks. We got to Canmore, and then my buddy left and went to the coast, and I became a failed hobo and went back to Ontario, and it didn't last. But, you know, I know that a lot of people out here in the West, you know, talk about their ancestors being hobos and sort of traveling around when guys were out of work back in the 40s. And, this song is about the orange crop failure that sort of happened in Florida during the 1940s. It was one of the worst orange crop failures of all time, I guess, just because of a freeze. And having no other places to work, really, at that time, coming out of the Great Depression, one of the places to find work was up in the Mesabi Iron Range, up in Minnesota, because they were starting up the steel mines up there again, the iron ore mines up there, to make enough steel for the war effort, because America was going off to fight fascism in Europe. And This song is about some guys who were out of work who were heading out that way.
Didn't quite make it because they had these storms that blow off Lake Superior.
Like in 1940, the armistice day blizzard, where people went to work without their coats on. It was like 19 degrees Celsius out. By the time they came to get home, you know, there was 10-foot drifts, these huge, huge storms. A lot of folks froze to death. And, you know, this is a song kind of about that. This is called Swing Your Lantern. And it's off our newest CD called Westbound to Light. And you guys can find it out there off my website or on Bandcamp or wherever you're finding music these days. So this is called Swing Your Lantern.
We're
stars are falling as we stumble out into that broken night. Dogs are barking on the edge of town out beyond the stolen light. Riders here on a westbound train pushed north by winter's hand. Long and gone from the great unknown, lost to the promised land. Thank you, guys. You guys are wonderful. Well, years ago, they asked me to be on a little compilation record.
It was for the Frank Slide disaster that happened out in the Crookness Pass region of Alberta.
And my mother-in-law has a place out there in Bellevue, and I go out every once in a while and do some writing. And they asked me to be on this record about 10 years ago. And I started writing this song about 10 years ago, and nothing worked on it. I just didn't like it. Didn't work. So needless to say, it didn't really make the record. But then I had this sort of natural disaster song about a big rock slide that I had kicking around for a while, and I was like, what the hell am I going to do with this song? And by the time I got to liking it, it was about 10 years old, and some friends said to me, well, you know, I mean, it's a song about Alberta. Why don't you put it in this Alberta songwriting contest? So I thought, okay, well, I'll do that. And when I was writing this song, I had sort of done some research into the mining history out there in the Crow's Nest Pass, and they were the first place in Canada to ever vote in a communist mayor. And I was like, oh, this is interesting. I don't know how long it lasted, but it was part of the history. And so I sort of wrote this little mining song with a little bit of a communist bent, and I entered it into this Alberta songwriting contest. And then I found out it was for a bank in Calgary. Needless to say, it didn't win. This is a song called You Can't Cheat the Mountain.
Screaming down old Turtle Mountain, just burying everyone. And the sky bled red that morning, red with prayers and bones. The stories born of the hills down there, the songs of the buried ones. You can't cheat the mountain, time ain't bought, you know it's borrowed. 70 tongues took wing that night, just stolen. Well, their blood long washed in the old man river from the town of Frank on down. And the wind still carries voices here from the ones who built this town. And their ghosts still run the broken seams, chained here in this world. We're buried in a Christian tomb of crow's nest stone there curled. You can't cheat the mountain, time ain't bought, you know it's borrowed. 70 tongues took wing that night, just stolen. There tomorrow. When it comes to promised paydays, you
You know, the black lungs always said, well, I'd rather walk in poverty than to be sleeping with the dead. Well, I'd rather walk in poverty than to be sleeping with the dead. Walk this world a millionaire and make the devil's bed. You can't cheat the mountain. Time ain't bought, you know it's borrowed. 70 tongues took wing that night, just stolen. If you ever do find yourself driving through Alberta on Highway 3, head down through the Crow's Nest Pass and you can see the big Frank's Slide. It's quite amazing. Almost close to a million tons of stone fell on this little town of Frank. Check it out. Interesting to note that the Blackfoot people at the time said, you know, that's not a really great place to put a village. Maybe don't do that. But they didn't listen. Well, I think I might have time for one more song. I got to thank everybody down here at the Medalta Pottery Factory and at the museum here, and everybody with the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club. Robert, all you guys volunteering down here, running the cameras, everything. This is an amazing, incredibly historic building in here. I don't know if everybody can see it, but it's an old vintage kiln where they used to fire up all sorts of amazing pottery down here at the Medalta Pottery Factory. So as an Alberta artist, this is really nice and incredibly historic to be here and be part of this. This is really cool. I thank you very much. I can hear the lights. I can hear the lights out there. I can hear the computer monitor motors and stuff. It's amazing. Thank you again, guys, for being here. Thanks for continuing to support live music through this process. You know, it's the weirdest time ever. I don't know that humans are equipped for this long of an emergency. It just keeps dragging on, and you know, it's like years. What's going on? Anyways, one of my heroes was definitely Townes Van Zandt, and he famously said, there are two types of music in this world. There's the blues, and there is zippity-doo-dah. And I have never really been accused of doing too much zippity-doo-dah. I always sort of loved that edge of things. You know, that my kind of music doesn't necessarily build accolades or, you know, prizes at events or any of that sort of stuff. You know, I mean, it kind of belongs on the other side of the red carpet. And I love music that way, you know. It's just the kind of music that I love. So, you know, I'd like to send this song out to all you singer-songwriters out there that are struggling through this entire pandemic, you know, trying to get out there and play. I know it's in your blood, and it's really, really tough, but just hold in there, keep playing. I mean, there's some great music out there on the internet. Check it out. I know it kind of, well, it's not like seeing music live, but we just can't do that right now. Still, hold in there. This is called Yonder. Faded blight of Willie Johnson humming Woody's
washed up old blues that's just lost John on the highway, wearing $1,000 shoes. And I'm wondering where they got to go and pass this way again. We gotta walk this road together, cause we all leave here alone. I'll see you yonder. I'll see you yonder. Somewhere. Further on. Well, I stole from darkness. Jesus, me to the light. Every thought of mine is wondering what the hell we did last night. One just disappears out here, cast off free from harm. All my doggone recollections have been taken to the farm. And I have wandered on the mountain, I've been lost out on the sea. I took my secrets to the river, and she threw them back at me. And I have heard the raven calling, I've listened to the pines, and every whisper from the silence is spoken out of line. I'll see you yonder. I'll see you yonder. Somewhere. Somewhere. Further on. Come this way before, if memory serves me right. And the ghosts of what we used to be have vanished in the night. Wanderlust fever that never lets me stay. And I'm waltzing out beyond the hills, advancing through the fray. I'll see you yonder. I'll see you yonder. I'll see you yonder. Somewhere. Somewhere. Further on.
Dave McCann, it's a pleasure to be here in Medicine Hat, Alberta, the Medalta, for the wonderful, incredible Tongue on the Post Folk Music Festival. And it's not quite the 15th version, is it? Or is it the 16th now? Okay. We'll see you again. You go to davemccann.com, find me on social media, friend me on YouTube or whatever you're on and whatever platform you're out there, and we'll see you down the road. Thanks for being here. Appreciate it, guys.
Wow. And how is that? I mean, it never disappoints to have you join us, Dave. You know, the comments that I've been receiving personally, you know, some of our mutual friends, I know Clayton's watching out in Toronto.
Well, great.
Right? You know, a number of individuals, just everybody's loving it.
That's the magic of the internet, right? I mean, it is really something else where you can play here and people from all over the world can tune in and see music. I mean, it's great. You don't even have to deal with parking in Medicine Hat, which is...
Yeah, no parking issues in Medicine Hat.
Yeah, there you go.
I mean, the... you know, we listen to your songs and the comments that I'm receiving back, and we're seeing in the comment section, you know, people really feel the ability to almost travel around the province and whatnot and be in places that you've been. And I definitely think that attests to your songwriting abilities as an artist. Do you make special trips to try and find these songs, or how do you find that process comes to you?
Well, these songs I don't necessarily make special trips, but you certainly get influenced by geography or wherever. But I mean, these songs just hit you wherever you are, and that's, you know, you're driving down the street, or you're in Stavely, Alberta, or you're, you know, in Toronto, or you're wherever you are, usually in a hotel room, and you start banging out a song. And it's just, you know, the really good ones just sort of come to you. The other ones you have to work on, you know, for longer. And I mean, there's no rhyme or reason. I gave up a long time ago trying to figure out how this works. It just works somehow.
It just, you know? It just flows from you.
For some reason, yeah.
You know, that's great. Beautiful thing. You know? So you had mentioned, you know, how it's kind of been a tough time for artists, and there's not a lot of opportunities to be playing right now. I mean, we're thankful to be having you here in Midelta. You know, this is a unique experience in a brick beehive kiln that most people don't get to stand in, let alone perform in.
Mm-hmm.
How have you managed to, you know, keep going through the
pandemic? Well, I guess I've just been lucky. You know, I've got some small kids at home, so I've been able to sort of look after them and keep busy with that. Like, I mean, if everybody else was gone during the pandemic, it would have been like writing time. But I was, you know, I was looking after my kids and hanging out and trying to make sense of the world myself. So, I mean, I didn't really have that time. But, I mean, the things that keep me going are certainly the simple fact that, I mean, I'm one person singing a song, but there's thousands of ears out there, and people are still listening and still tuning in and live streams. And it just was a testament to how much people love live music, you know? I mean, when the pandemic first started happening, it was like every news conference was like, there's absolutely no singing. You can sing to three people in a church only, you know, and I mean, all this sort of stuff. So as a professional musician, you're kind of like, what is going on? The world is sort of vaporized, you know, and I mean, now here I am singing into a little tiny iPhone to, you know, thousands of people. So, I mean, it's changed. And I mean, as a musician, you know, I mean, you live with a certain amount of uncertainty. So maybe, you know, you're kind of prepared for a little bit of pandemic time. You know, it's like, what's going to happen next? What happens after sound check? You never know, right? So, I mean, you know, it's like that for everyone. I mean, there's so many people out there doing incredible work. I mean, nurses, teachers, these incredible women through our province that are doing amazing, amazing work, holding up the slack for this stuff. And you know what I mean? And it's just part of watching your community come together and do that sort of stuff and being responsible and getting out there and making these choices to, you know, maybe bring this world into a better spot. So, I mean, I'm enthralled by it. You know, it's personally, I've been able to thrive through that experience and not be, you know, taken down by it, you know, so.
And we're thankful for artists like yourself that have been able to make this a manageable time in our lives, where you know, we were able to rely on artists like yourselves and help us get through it with these songs and heartfelt messages, right?
Well, we'd be nothing without people like you that are putting on the music and doing the hard work and doing the heavy lifting behind the scenes, you know? Well, it's easy for me to get up here in front of a couple cameras and sing some songs, but, you know, I mean, there's a lot of people and there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes, and it is a lot of work, you know? It's like any other job, so we appreciate you guys.
And none of it could happen without all you guys at home. You know, we've seen the donations coming in. We greatly appreciate the donations. You know, your donations help to continue programming like this, so we're able to present artists like this in a manner that we're able to in a safe manner and continue the music coming and not turning away the festival. You know, generally we do a cafe concert series throughout the week. This week we're unable to do that at this point, but we have an amazing community and city behind us that's, you know, we're going to present that in another month or two when things are able to, and continue just putting music in the group.
Yeah, adapting and moving forward. I mean, what else can you do, right? I mean, it's just like, not much, you know? It's amazing to see that. So, I mean, it's pretty inspiring to see people out there doing clever stuff and being inspired through this process, because, you know, it can't be tough. It can be a downer.
Absolutely. Know? And we can't thank you enough for being here and joining us.
Well, thank you. And again, thank you guys out there for listening and being a part of this, and everybody down here in Medicine Hat for putting on this event and getting behind it. So it's great. Honor to be here, for sure.
It's our pleasure. And speaking of, you know, looking out for one another and taking care of each other and community support, you know, a dear friend of ours, you know, friend of the festival is Dan Howard. He performed last year. You know, sadly, he's gone through some very struggling medical issues in the last few weeks, and so we've taken this next hour to honor Dan and be able to, you know, any support that we can send Dan's way. We want to be able to look out for one another here in the community, you know, in the music community, as well as, you know, the amazing community of Medicine Hat. And so, you know, actually, Dan just messaged a couple minutes ago to say how much he loved tuning into your performance and couldn't wait. You know, he's at home recovering, just got back a couple of days ago from the hospital, you know, 3 weeks in the hospital.
Wow.
And so, you know, with that being said, like, we really try and look out for one another, you know, like I said, in the community as well as in the music community, and anything we can do to try and support each other through these times, that's what we're going to do. And so, that being said, let's take the opportunity and we'll present Dan Howard. You know, we love you a lot. We miss you. We hope you heal up quick, and we can't wait to have you back, you know, playing in the music scene here. And we hope you all enjoy this next rendition of Dan.
Well, hello, everybody. Before I start playing, I just want to give due thanks to Plugged In Media for the production, definitely to the Medicine Hat Folk Music Club for having me here, and Al's Audio for providing the sound. And yeah, you know, I also want to dedicate this show to all the people that I couldn't be with at Christmas, and all the friends and family that I wish I could entertain in person. So this is dedicated to you, and this is close we can get right now, and I'm definitely appreciative that we have this opportunity to do this. So without further ado, as said, I'm going to play songs from my album. The album was called From Dark to Light. I released it in December of 2019, planning to promote it throughout the year of 2020. And, you know, I've done what I can, and it is what it is, but I'm very happy to be able to play these songs for you now. The first song on the album is a song that is basically written about those who are struggling with mental illness, but anything that you're struggling with, and the song is called Hold On to the Beautiful.
Must bear. Oh. gets you down, it'll keep your feet on the ground. Hold on to the beautiful. Hold on to the beautiful. Hold on to the beautiful. When life gets you down,
thank you. I do have a few people here live. This is exciting for me. You know, it's nice just to even hang around with people. A lot of fun. Next song I'm going to sing is another song from my album. It's based on, well, I knew some people quite well who were in a long-term relationship, and things broke apart. But the one partner thought it would be okay to put the other one in the friend zone. And anyways, that doesn't always work out. So I was inspired to write this song called If I Can't Call You Baby. Oh.
and call you again, baby. I can't call you again.
All right, thank you. Thanks a lot. It's hot in this kiln. People don't realize they're making pottery right over there. Like, it is hot. I'm thirsty. So this next song here is kind of interesting. It's also off my album. The song is called Blind in This World. And it's interesting because I took contributions from a couple of my music students. A brother and sister, Michaela Stenbeck, actually provided the lyrics for the chorus. And her brother, Billy Stenbeck, he actually came up with the four-chord progression that I based this song off of. And with their blessing, they have credits on my album, and they're quite excited about that. Anyways, the song is called Blind in This World.
just showing hey, like a brotherhood of man. All we've got is each other.
The next tune I have is a little different for me for a couple reasons. I'm going to use a capo, a cheater as my dad would have called him. So if he's watching this, he'll get a chuckle. Also, it was produced on my album to sound really, really poppy, and you guys have never heard the version I'm going to play here now, so it'll be interesting. The song is called In the Kitchen There Is Love, and the reason being that I wanted to dedicate it to all the people who make the kitchen the heart of the home. My mother did that for me, and I'm very thankful. I have good memories. And my wife, Marla, has done the same in our home. So I wrote this song for those people.
There's a paper by the entryway you met. Down the hallway stands a hanger where he hangs his coat and hat. In the living room, a family. One he is so proud of. But as he goes a little further, he knows in the kitchen there is love. In the kitchen there is love, unlike any other. In the kitchen there is love, pure and true. In the kitchen there are memories of celebrations, good times, bad times, situations that prove. In the kitchen there is love. In the kitchen there is love. Children are all sleeping. Another long day behind. We both head off to the kitchen to catch up on the time. Holding hands across the table, I stop to thank the Lord above for this woman who is able fill our house with love. In the kitchen there is love, unlike any other. In the kitchen there is love, pure and true. In the kitchen there is food prepared with love and care. Everything our hearts desire was there. In the the kitchen, every love. In the kitchen, there is 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 love.
Hey, hey, no dancing back there. Wait, I saw some dancing. You got your mask on, though, that's good. So, here's another song off my album. This one here, again, I wrote kind of based off a conversation that other people have and things that other people are going through. I guess that says something about me, but hey, I'm an observer anyways. This song is actually called Heart of Stone, and I know it's not the most original title, but the story came about because I had a good friend a few years back, and she had been a single mom and hadn't had much luck with romance anyways, and there was finally a really nice guy in her life, and he loved her a lot, and she confided in me that she just couldn't love him back for some unknown reason. She said, I think I might be broken inside, maybe I can't fall in love. And I just pondered that, because I never thought of those things before, and I wrote a song out of it. So the song is called Heart of Stone.
Down
Bit of a rocking tune. It's a bit of a rocking tune, but there's one more that's a little more rocking on my album. I kind of put it on there just because, you know, it had to be there, because the fact of the matter is, rock and roll is my lullaby. Well, it's almost like having a real audience. Okay, where's the chicks? Where's the chicks? Is there still one here? That's okay. Rob told me he thinks there's one chick that's going to really be impressed with me tonight when I get home. Having played in the Kiln and everything, you know what I'm talking about. You know, I actually have to tune my guitar. I respect my audience that much. Do it as quick as I can, too, and I wish I knew more jokes. Those who are just tuning in, that tuning only took me like 5 seconds. So there you go. All right, so the next tune that I have here is also off my album. And this one here, again, it's another song of hope, I guess. I'm full of hope. So there you go. I hope some of it rubs off on you guys. This tune is called After the Fire.
Remember, after the fire comes.
comes the rain. Ooh. After the fire, always comes the rain. After the fire, always comes the rain.
Time? 15 minutes about? So that concludes the songs that were on my album From Dark to Light, and hopefully by listening to it you'll realize why I entitled it that. Most of the songs are songs of hope and songs of seeking, and if you wanted to check out my album, you can go on my website. It's danhowardmusic.net. My music is all available there. You could also check it out on iTunes if you'd like. And if you want to follow me on Facebook, it's also Dan Howard Music. Anyways, a few years ago, I met someone who clued me into some interesting things and suggested that there's such things as twin flames, meaning people who come to Earth and meet up inevitably because they're connected. So I thought that was quite cool, and I wrote a song about it. It's not on my album, it's a newer single, but it is also still available.
We're destined to birth.
say, yeah, we're all burning with the flames. Haven't I seen you before? Don't I recognize your smile? Don't I know you from somewhere? That sparkle in your eyes. Always together, again and again. Yeah, we'll.
I was hoping I could sing at least one cover tune before my time was up. Is that okay? All right, I'm gonna do one here. And for those of you that know that I've been up to lately, you'll appreciate this song of freedom.
All I ever had, damn
Are we close enough? Is that good? I got time for one more? Okay, all right. Well, you know what? I'm going to do one more cover then, too, because I've already come this far. Here's one I'd like to sing for you guys. This one means a lot to me because Chris Cornell was one of my favorite singers, as some people know, and this cover that he did before he passed was amazing. So the song is called Nothing Compares to You, and I dedicate it to Chris Cornell. Again.
It's been 7 hours and 15 days since you took your love away. Last day out. Thank you.
figured that'd be about it now, but thanks again to everyone who tuned in, especially to the people who organized this. We don't know the work that they had to go through to make this even happen, so huge round of applause for that, and hopefully we can do it in person again very soon. Thank you, everyone.
We got Mike, and we got Mike, Dan Howard. That was absolutely phenomenal. We're pulling for you at home, Dan. We definitely show a lot of love. I know there's a lot of love and support in the community for you. We live in a beautiful city that really helps support all of us. That being said, I'd like to thank everybody for joining us today. Day 4 of Tongue on the Post. We've got 2 headlining specials coming up, Friday and Saturday. We've got some amazing shows ahead, and we want you to join us. They both go live at 5 p.m. Friday and Saturday from Adelta with 3 acts. Want to be able to thank a bunch of our sponsors, the City of Medicine Hat, Alberta Music, Canadian Heritage, the beautiful Adelta Potteries. We couldn't make any of this possible without the help and support from Al's Audio and Plugged In Media Network. Made a special new partnership with Medicine Hat College, some help and support from ArtsFest, a phenomenal organization that's been working with us this year. We can't say enough about the support that's been put through to the music and into the arts during this this time. We appreciate being able to share all this with you. And again, if you have the opportunity, please donate as it helps continue programming for the future and being able to present more opportunities like this. We hope you've all enjoyed the week so far, and we can't wait to see you in the next couple of days. Have a great day.